Fact number two, on the Sunday after his crucifixion, Jesus' tomb was found empty by a group of his women followers. Among the reasons that have led most scholars to this conclusion are the following. One, the old information transmitted by Paul implies the empty tomb. It does so in two ways. First, the expression, "he was raised," following the expression, "he was buried," implies an empty grave. A first century Jew could not have thought otherwise. Second, the expression, "on the third day," is probably a reference to the day of the women's discovery of the empty tomb. Thus, we have two extremely early indications of the fact of the empty tomb. Number two, the empty tomb story is also part of Mark's very old source material. Mark's source didn't end with Jesus' burial, but with the empty tomb narrative, which is tied to the burial account verbally and grammatically. And thus, we have very early, independent attestation of the fact of the empty tomb. Three, the story is simple and lacks signs of legendary embellishment. In Mark's account, the women come to the tomb early Sunday morning and find the stone rolled away and the tomb empty. They see an angelic figure who proclaims to them that Jesus is risen and will appear to them in Galilee. Then they flee from the tomb in terror and silence. Now, to appreciate the simplicity of this account, one has only to compare it to the accounts in the forged apocryphal Gospels of the second century and beyond. They're colored by all sorts of apologetical and theological motifs, which are conspicuously missing from the stark account in Mark. Four, the tomb was probably discovered empty by women. In Jewish society, the testimony of women was regarded as so unreliable that, according to Josephus, they were not even permitted to serve as witnesses in a Jewish court of law. Now, in light of this fact, how remarkable it is that it is women who are the discoverers of Jesus' empty tomb. Any later legendary account would certainly have made male disciples like Peter and John discover the empty tomb. But the gospel writers faithfully record what, for them, was an awkward and embarrassing fact. Five, the earliest Jewish response presupposes the empty tomb. What were Jews saying in response to the disciples' proclamation, "He is risen from the dead"? That these men were drunk? That the body still lay in the tomb in the garden? No, they said the disciples came and stole away his body. Matthew 28:13. Now think about that for a second. The disciples came and stole away his body. The earliest Jewish response to the proclamation of the resurrection was itself an attempt to explain why the body was missing. Thus, we have evidence for the empty tomb from the very enemies of the early Christian movement. I could go on, but I think enough has been said to indicate why, in the words of Jakob Kramer, an Austrian specialist on the resurrection, by far most scholars hold firmly to the reliability of the biblical statements concerning the empty tomb.